Next, we will discuss universal gate. In universal gate, we have to discuss NAND gate and NOR gate. So, I will be starting with NAND gate. So, NAND gate, you can say, is a combination of AND gate with NOT gate. Simple words, we can say NAND gate is a combination of AND gate and NOT gate, or I can say NAND gate is an AND gate followed by a NOT gate. AND gate followed by a NOT gate, like this. AND gate followed by a NOT gate, followed by a NOT gate, followed by a NOT gate. So, let me name the inputs as A, B and C. So, inputs applied to an AND gate, output of an AND gate is applied to the NOT gate. So, what I am saying, AND gate followed by a NOT gate. So, what is an output of an AND gate? Output of an AND gate is A dot B dot C. And what is the work of an NOT gate? A NOT gate is also called as inverter, because it inverts the logic. So, NOT gate is also called as inverter. So, what is the work of a NOT gate? Is to complement the logic. Complement the logic of the input to the output. So, complement of the logic means the output will become A dot B dot C whole complement. Output will become whole complement of the input. For a NOT gate, output is whole complement of the input. Now, this work of an inverter can also be replaced by a bubble, as I have discussed sometimes before. Sometimes before in this video. Now, this work of a NOT gate can be simply done with the help of a bubble. Work of a NOT gate can be done with a simple bubble. This inverter was doing the complement of the input. This bubble will also do the same thing. So now let me consider the same inputs A, B and C. Now I will directly write down the output as A dot B dot C whole complement. So the complement logic is done with the help of this bubble. So, I have discussed before also, this bubble simply represents inversion. This bubble simply represents inversion. So, what I have done, I have simplified the logic symbol. So, this is the simplified logic symbol for an NAND gate. Now, coming to the truth table. So, again, we have two main columns, inputs and outputs. Inputs are A, B and C. I will have an intermediate column in this one also, and the intermediate column will be Y is A dot B dot C, and final output column Y is equal to A dot B dot C whole complement. Final output column A dot B dot C. So now these are the columns that we will be fill, that we will fill step by step. Again, we have three inputs. Now, as discussed, we are not going to write low and high now. Now, we can switch to zeros and ones directly. Now, the inputs have 8 combinations, 3 inputs has 8 combinations. Now writing it in zeros and ones, so the first combination is 000, next combination is 1, Next combination is 010, 011, 100, 101, 110, 111. So we have 8 combinations for 3 inputs. This is basically AND gate. So what happens in an AND gate is, if any input is at logic 0, output is also at logic 0. If any input is at logic 0, output is also at logic 0. And output is logic 1 only when all the inputs are 1. Output is logic 1 only when all the inputs are at logic 1. Now we have to complement the logic. This is A dot B dot C. This is complement of A dot B dot C. Complement means all the zeros will be complemented to 1. All the zeros will be complemented to 1s, and this one will be complemented to 0. This one will be complemented to 0. So this is a complete NAND gate, which is AND gate followed by a NOT gate. AND gate followed by a NOT gate. So simply, combination of AND gate and NOT gate is NAND gate. Now coming to the statement. So first let me explain, then I will dictate. So now what we can notice here is that output is logic high when any of the input is at logic 0. Output is logic high when any of the input is at logic 0. And output is logic 0. Output is logic 0 only when all the inputs are 1. Output is logic 0 only when all the inputs are at logic 1. But I will dictate this statement in terms of logic high and logic low, which now you can understand. Start writing. NAND gate is a logic gate whose output is at logic high when any of the inputs is at logic low. Any of the inputs is at logic low. Next statement. NAND gate is a logic gate whose output is at logic low only when All the inputs are at logic high. Output is logic low only when all the inputs are at logic high. All the inputs are at logic high. Now let us look some more details about NAND gate, for which I am starting a table. So see the tables. See the columns of the tables. So first let the input be A and B, then the columns A complement and B complement. Next column is A dot B whole complement. Next column is A complement plus B complement. Since we have only two inputs, we will be having four combinations in this table. So two inputs, four combinations, and the four combinations will be 00, 01, 10 and 11. Now let us complete the table. So column A is 0011. So complement of A will be 1100. Column B is 0101. Complement of B will be 1010. Now A dot B whole complement is a NAND gate, and for a NAND gate I know if any of the input is 0, output is 1. If any of the input is 0, output is 1, and when all the inputs are 1, output is 0. This is basically plus of A complement and B complement. So, A complement plus B complement. Plus means OR gate. So, this is an OR gate for A complement and B complement. What happens in an OR gate is, if any input is 1, output is also equal to 1. If any input is 1, output is also equal to 1, and when all the inputs are 0, output is also equal to 0. So, what I can notice from this one is that, A dot B whole complement is equal to A complement plus B complement. What I can notice is A dot B whole complement is equal to A complement plus B complement. Now, what is A complement plus B complement? A complement plus B complement is the OR gate of A complement and B complement. A complement plus B complement is an OR gate. A complement and B complement is an OR gate of A complement and B complement. OR gate of A complement and B complement. So, it is an OR gate of A complement and B complement. Now, how to obtain A complement is using NOT gate. So, using NOT gate, I will design A complement as well as I will design B complement using NOT gate. Okay. Now, see, A given to a NOT gate, output will be A complement. B given to a NOT gate, output is B complement. Applied to an OR gate is A complement plus B complement. Now, the way in which we can replace, if there is an NOT gate at the output of any gate, I can replace it with a bubble. In the same way, if the NOT gate is at the input, then also I can replace with a bubble. Let me show here. So, in this OR gate, we will replace, the input with the bubbles. We will replace the inputs with this bubble. So, if the input is A and B, output is A complement plus B complement. What I have done here, let me tell you once again, please come. I am saying the way in which I can replace the NOT gate at the output of any gate. I can replace the NOT gate at the output of any gate with simply a bubble. NOT gate at the output of any gate can be replaced simply with a bubble. In the same way, please see, the NOT gate at the input of the any other gate can be replaced with a bubble. The NOT gate at the input of any gate can be replaced with a bubble. Now, we have discussed A complement plus B complement is equal to A dot B whole complement. And this A dot B whole complement is nothing but your NAND gate. A dot B whole complement. Is nothing but output of a NAND gate. So, what we can conclude here, that these two notations are equivalent. Okay. So, now we know this is a NAND gate. This is a NAND gate that we know very well. Now you can see this is an OR gate with bubbled input. This is an OR gate with bubbled input. So you can call this as bubbled OR gate. You can call this as bubbled OR gate because it is an OR gate with the bubbled inputs. This is an OR gate with the bubbled inputs. So this is bubbled OR gate. This can also be called as active low OR gate, and it is also called as negative OR gate. So this gate can be termed as bubbled OR gate, active low OR gate, negative OR gate. Okay, this gate can be named using any of the three terms, and obviously this A dot B whole complement, is equal to A complement plus B complement. Obviously, these two expressions. So, the way these two expressions are equal, in the same way, these two notations or these two representations are also equivalent. So, A dot B whole complement is equal to A complement plus B complement. So, this NAND gate is equivalent to a bubbled OR gate or active low OR gate or negative OR gate. Now, we will discuss why NAND gate is a universal gate. For this, first my aim will be to design all the three basic gates using NAND gate, and then I will explain you by designing all the three basic gates how I can declare NAND gate as a universal gate. So for that, first let me design all the three basic gates using NAND gate, then I will do the justification part also. So first let me start with a NOT gate. Now if you will observe the expression of a NAND gate. So if the inputs are A and B, the output expression is A dot B whole complement. Now if I combine both the inputs, so there will be a single input A. It means this terminal input is also A and this terminal input is also A. So, according to the expression of a NAND gate, this output will become A dot A whole complement, which is equal to A complement. So, this is a NOT gate which I have designed using a NAND gate. Same, now I will try for AND gate. So, my target is to design AND gate using NAND gate. So, what is the output expression of a NAND gate? So, output expression of a NAND gate is A dot B whole complement. If somehow I can remove the whole complement, it will become AND gate. So, how to remove the whole complement is simply using a NOT gate. Using a NOT gate, it was already a single complement, it will become a double complement. And we know A dot B double complement can be written as A dot B. So this is an AND gate with the help of a NAND gate. But this is not a completely NAND gate structure, obviously, because I am using a NOT gate. But you can see here, using NAND gate, I have designed a NOT gate. So this structure I will replace at this position. So now you can see this is an AND gate whose output is A dot B whole complement, So now replacing NAND gate in place of a inverter. So actually this is NAND, this NAND gate is also acting as an inverter. You can see here, this NAND gate when I combine both the input terminal acts like a NOT gate only. So this is nothing but acting like a NOT gate only. So this will become A dot B. So now this complete structure is your AND gate. So what I can conclude, two NAND gates required for AND gate. And in the same way, what I can conclude here, one NAND gate required for NOT gate. So two of the three basic gates we have done. Now the third one is the OR gate. Now if you will analyze the required expression is A plus B. And we definitely know A plus B can be written as A plus B double complement. Now at this position, I am using a very basic Boolean law of De Morgan's law that you must be knowing. Even if you are not aware, you can just note it down. I will discuss it in detail and then we will use it in Boolean algebra as well. Now this A plus B double complement, if I use Boolean algebra on this one, I mean exactly I can say if I use De Morgan's theorem in this one, this will become A complement dot B complement whole complement. A plus B whole complement replaced with A complement dot B complement, and one whole complement remains as it is. So just I have used very basic De Morgan's law at this place. Now if you will analyze this expression, this expression can be obtained from output of a NAND gate. This expression can be obtained from the output of a NAND gate if the inputs are A complement and B complement. What will be the output expression of a NAND gate? Output expression of a NAND gate will be A complement dot B complement whole complement, which is the same thing. And this is equal to A plus B. So this is equal to A plus B. So we can design A plus B using a NAND gate if the inputs are A complement and B complement. And we now very well know how to design A complement and how to design B complement using NAND gate, because it needs a NOT gate, and we have just learned how to implement a NAND gate like a NOT gate. For this, I have told you just connect both the input terminals to the same point. So now this NAND gate input terminals connected. Again, this NAND gate input terminals connected. This NAND gate, same I am repeating here. So you can see we have implemented A plus B. How we have implemented? See, this input is A, this is a NOT gate, so this becomes A complement. This input is B, this is the NOT gate, this becomes B complement. A complement and B complement applied to a NAND gate is nothing but A plus B that we already seen. So this complete structure is giving me the output expression of an OR gate, that is A plus B, for which I need three NAND gates. So I can declare I need three NAND gates for OR gate. So first part we have done, we have implemented all the basic gates using NAND gate. Now consider you have to implement a function using basic gates. So function A complement B plus C, you have to implement using basic gates. So it is a very easy task, but still it is required for the analysis and the conclusion. So I am doing this question. For this A complement, we simply need NOT gate. For this A complement, we simply need NOT gate. So this will convert A to A complement. Now A complement dot B. For this, I need AND gate. For this, I need AND gate with the second input B. So this will give you A complement B. Now for this plus C, I need an OR gate. I need an OR gate with the input C. So this will give you A complement B plus C. So I know this was the easy task, but still required for the analysis and the conclusion, as I said. Now I have taken a very simple example and I have implemented using basic gates. Now you can consider any function, any Boolean function with any complexity, any number of input, 100% you can design it using basic gates. I am not saying with only AND gate, with only OR gate, with only NOT gate, but with the combination of these gates. So what I am saying, we can design any function of any complexity with the combination of basic gates. That is why these gates are called as basic gates, because with their help and with their combination, we can design any given function. So we can design any function with the help of all the basic gates. That is why these three gates are called as basic gates. Now what we have learned, I can design a NAND gate, I can design a NOT gate using NAND gate, I can design AND gate using NAND gate, I can design OR gate using NAND gate. Now let me replace all the basic gates with the NAND gates as we have studied just now. So now how to replace a NOT gate? How to replace a NOT gate? How to replace a NOT gate is like this. This is a NOT gate using NAND gate. Now for the AND gate, I need two NAND gates as discussed. So this is my AND gate. So one input is A complement, second input is B. So this is AND gate. So this will give me A complement B. Now for the OR gate, I need three NAND gates. For the OR gate, I need three NAND gates. So one input is A complement B and the next input is C. So this will give me A complement B plus C. So now you can look in this way that this is your NAND gate, sorry, this is your NOT gate, which we have implemented using NAND gate. This combination is NAND gate. And what about this combination? This combination is OR gate. So see it this way, this is a NOT gate converting A to A complement. This is an AND gate, A complement dot B. This is an OR gate, A complement B plus C, but we have designed it using NAND gate. Now you can understand, if I can implement any Boolean function using these three basic gates, and now we can very well see all the basic gates can be designed using NAND gate. So I can simply say I can design any function using only NAND gates. I can design any function using only NAND gates. Now let me just give it to you in writing. So now using, see what I am saying, I can design any given Boolean function with the combination of basic gates. So see, AND gate plus OR gate plus NOT gate. With the combination of all the three basic gates, I can design given Boolean function, given Boolean function of any complexity, of any complexity, of any complexity like this. This one. This is how I started. With the combination of these three gates, I can design any given Boolean function of any complexity. That is why these gates are called as basic gates. And then what I concluded, with the NAND gate, I can design AND gate, I can design OR gate, I can design NOT gate. So I can conclude, with the NAND gate, I can design a given Boolean function of any complexity. I can design a given Boolean function of any complexity. So this is the justification why these gates are called as basic gates, and this gate is called as universal gate, because it can single-handedly implement any Boolean function. These gates are single-handedly not capable, but their combination can design any given Boolean function. This is the difference between basic gates and universal gate. Universal gate is single-handedly sufficient, and combination of basic gates is required to design any given Boolean function. Now you can write down, I will dictate you, I will write down whatever I have explained in this diagram. Write down. We can design a given Boolean function. We can design a given Boolean function of any complexity, of any complexity, of any complexity, with the combination of AND gate, with the combination of AND gate, comma OR gate and NOT gate, comma OR gate and NOT gate. So these gates are called as basic gates. So these gates are called as basic gates. These gates are called as basic gates. Next. Now, in the next line, you can start writing. All the three basic gates can be designed. All the three basic gates can be designed using only NAND gate. Using only NAND gate. So we can conclude that it is possible to design it is possible to design a given Boolean function. It is possible to design a given Boolean function of any complexity, given Boolean function of any complexity, of any complexity, of any complexity, using only NAND gates, using only NAND gates. You can write only in capital letters, ONLY, only in capital letters, using only NAND gates, full stop. Hence NAND gate is called universal gate. Hence NAND gate is called universal gate. Hence NAND gate is called universal gate. In the next line, you can write a note. What we are going to write in the note is that whatever discussion we have done for NAND gate, the same discussion is valid for NOR gate as well. Okay, so write it down. Note, N-O-T-E, underline and then write. All the above discussion for NAND gate, all the above discussion for NAND gate is also valid for NOR gate. Is also valid for NOR gate. Is also valid for NOR gate.